are blessed with carols. And so it is my great pleasure to invite the multi-talented practitioner, singer, jeweler, baker of cheesecakes, and other goodies to the podium for this morning's message.
Good morning. Well, today I'm just the practitioner, okay? Soren Kierkegaard has said, "Life can only be lived forward, but can only be understood backward." I've heard it put another way. Life is the hardest teacher. First she gives you the test, then she gives you the lesson. Have you ever wanted something so badly you could taste it, touch it, live it in your dreams? But when it came to doing what was necessary to actually achieve it, you backed away, didn't follow through. Anybody ever felt like that? What would cause you to shut it down? One word, fear. Big old fear. You know, excuse me. Recently, I was invited on a trip to meet a friend overseas, and I really wanted to go. But when I checked the ticket prices, it would have been horrendously expensive at the time. You know, last minute ticket booking is not never a good idea. Plus, I just didn't have the money to splurge. I'm renovating my kitchen. So my friend said, "Oh, no problem, don't worry about it. Let's plan for next year when you can book early enough and get a good ticket price." Fair enough, right? Now, any normal person would have said, "Okay, something great to look forward to." Now, I never said I was normal, right? My response? You know when everything about you tighten up, your shoulder, your jaw corner, your stomach, right? Beads of sweat. Yeah, that was me. I had to stop and ask myself, why am I reacting this way? It's not the end of the world. Well, it sent me straight to my journal, and I started to write. That's a very good idea. If you haven't tried journaling, do it. Well, 4 pages later, you know what came up for me? I don't like to plan. Now, I had no idea that this was such a big deal for me. But it turned out that at the crux of that was a big, big fear. I don't like to plan because I don't like to be disappointed. I tell myself, or more like I fool myself into thinking, that is because I prefer spontaneity. You know, I think, I decide, I act in the moment. Right. If truth be told, I don't like to plan because if I have fewer expectations, I can't be disappointed. If I make no demands, I can't be told no. I wrote in big, bold letters in my journal, "What kind of life is that? Carol, is that the life you want?" Well, of course not. But when you're in panic mode, which I was, that's when all the what ifs start to pop up. No? What if a year from now I'm not even here? What if a year from now he doesn't want me to come? What if, what if, what if? I can hear you all thinking, you know. And you're all thinking right now, she's a practitioner. How can she have such thoughts and feelings? It's simple. Understand this. When these thoughts and feelings well up, it's not an indictment on me or on you, because you have them too, right? It doesn't mean that I'm a failure. What it means is that there's something that needs to be addressed. Something in my thought process that needs to be cleared. Now I realized very quickly that these emotions were stirring up feelings of unworthiness, which were a holdover from my insecure adolescent years. Back then, I was convinced I was really not worthy, and so I was afraid to dream. I was afraid to dream just in case it didn't happen, I would be exposed as the fraud that I was. Great practitioner words, right? I'm human, as are all of us. I had issues. Now, I honestly thought I had dealt with that stuff, and it was long gone. Yet here I was, feeling, how dare you plan for a dream holiday? I didn't say it out loud, but that's what my deep down feeling was telling me. Dr. Ernest Holmes, the founder of religious science, says in the Says Science of Mind textbook, and I quote, "The universe will never deny us anything unless we conceive that it is possible for us to think of something that is impossible for the universe to produce. Everyone who asks receives according to his belief." The Bible puts it a little simpler. Ask and it shall be given. When you pray, believe that you have it and you shall have it. No doubt, no fear, no stomach doing cartwheels, okay? But when we mess up, either through faulty thinking or stupid actions, which we do from time to time, no? It's just a mistake. It's not a cosmic problem, as Reverend John likes to say. It's just an experience, an opportunity to learn something new and to self-correct our direction, our trajectory. You know, at any point on any pathway, if you're headed in a particular direction and you discover along the way that's not really where I want to go, you don't have to keep going that way. At any point in time, you can stop and say, okay, where is it that I really want to go? And then change your direction to go where it is you really want to go. If you jump on a bus and you want to go to Mona and you find the bus is going to Crossroads, you don't stay on the bus, right? You come off, you say, stop, wrong bus. You come off and you jump on the bus that's going to Mona. Now, most, maybe all of us, exist under a blanket of fear. Some have a little receiving blanket, some have a big old king-size duvet. But we're all cowering under something, if we're honest. Big or little, it doesn't matter. If there's a little niggling fear in there, it's still fear. It may be the fear of not being good enough, or of being too good, or of feeling inadequate to a particular task, or that maybe we're not creative enough for whatever it is we need to do. Or we fear being successful. That's a big fear for a lot of people. No? Now, isn't it time that we let go of our self-destructive patterns and behaviors and get out of our own way? We can't continue to hide out and expect to progress, to grow and expand. We can't continue to deny our power and expect to step into our greatness. Don't stay attached or shackled to who you have been up until this point. It's not nearly so important as who you can be, because who you can be exists here, here, in your imagination. That's the kingdom of God. Here's an affirmation. I'll read it and then you can say it with me. Releasing any old stories that hold me back, I dive enthusiastically into life. I choose to forgive and move on. So, releasing any old stories that hold me back, I dive enthusiastically into life. I choose to forgive and move on.
And move on.
I don't sound like we don't wake up yet. That dive didn't sound very enthusiastic at all. Can we try this again? Releasing any old stories that hold me back.
I dive enthusiastically into life.
I choose to forgive
and move on.
And so it is. We have to be willing to let go and step into the unknown. Now, most of us fear the unknown. Now, you know, it said the devil you know is better than the angel you don't know. Well, something like that anyway. We're afraid to step into the void. But the void is where all possibility exists. We weren't put on this earth to suffer. Banish the thought. We came here to live full out, till we're all used up. But no, not used up like the suck-out juice bag. Used up as in live out the truest and the highest vision for ourselves till our last breath. No more dreams left on the cutting board. No desires wasting away on the shelf. We would have used fully our value as a human being. That's why we're here. Until then, we're not done here. Do you understand? Live full out, no excuses. It is our responsibility to allow ourselves to grow and expand into our dream. The dream takes us beyond our present reality, forever and ever expanding. Do you know, whatever it is you're dreaming right now, is giving form and expression to our next experience, the next moment, ad infinitum. So we better be prepared to catch up and not dawdle in indecision and procrastination and fear, or the dream is going to leave us behind. Now, how do you direct that energy in a way that bolsters your confidence and supports your growth into a larger idea? Well, first of all, whose life is it? Not yours. So stop asking for permission to live your best life. It's your life. You decide. Declare your intention. Announce your game plan and unlock your own door to new possibilities. Our past experience does not define us. Our current intention does. So stop telling that same old tired story. Interrupt your narrative. That tired old story is not your story now. Believe it or not, your fear is the most boring thing about you. Nobody's interested. Okay? Resist the temptation to rehash the look what happened to me back then, that's why I'm so afraid, so that you can feel vindicated and justified in your current situation. If the situation isn't moving you forward, you're stuck in the mud of cruddy thinking. Stop. Stop. Do you realize that you are the only you that's ever been and that ever will be? You are the only you there is. You are the original. That's extra special value. You have a right to demand the best for yourself. How you show up in the world is entirely up to you. There is no precedent. You are it. Right here, right now, you decide. Who do you want to be? Create the highest, the grandest vision for your life. banish the illusion once and for all that you are not in control of your life. You and you alone are the creator of your reality. How does that make you feel? Feel good? Feel uncomfortable? Feel like you're sitting on a tack? Feel like, if I'm the creator of my life, then why does it look like this? It's up to you. There is a power greater than yourself working in you, through you, for you, as you. The universe is just waiting to reveal the knowledge that you need, to gift you with the means and the energy to create what you want. As Dr. Holmes puts it in the Science of Mind textbook, and I quote, "Life is a blessing or a curse according to the use we make of it. The universe holds nothing against us. No matter how many mistakes we have made, we are still perfect beings within, and the within can become the without." How does that make you feel? Here's another affirmation for you. I'll read it through once. I am brilliant now. I am the wisdom of God made manifest now. My ideas are the possibility of infinite transformation. Ready? I am brilliant now. I am the wisdom of God made manifest now.
I am the wisdom of God made manifest now.
My ideas are the possibility of infinite transformation.
My ideas are the
possibility of infinite transformation. Now, if you look in your program, this being Practitioner Sunday, I have included a flyer. It's just some information about what a practitioner is and what a practitioner does. Any of you ever use the services of a practitioner? How many of you know what a practitioner is? Okay? I think sometimes we take for granted that because we talk about this thing all the time, that everybody understands what it is we're talking about. So I invite you, I'm not going to go through the whole thing, but I just invite you to take this with you and read through it. Centers for Spiritual Living is an international organization, okay? And what we call practitioners in here are licensed through the organization to do specific spiritual work with you and with ourselves as well, okay? Now, the licensed practitioners for this center are listed in the back of your program. I would encourage you to avail yourselves of the services that we offer. How do you know you need a practitioner? Are you too close to the problem to see the situation clearly? Do you feel that there's something blocking what you're seeking? Do you feel you lack the experience, the training, or the understanding of Science of Mind principles to resolve the difficulty? That's where we come in as practitioners. We can help to clarify what it is that you're really wanting to express. And we do this through what is called spiritual mind treatment or affirmative prayer. Now, all the things I spoke about this morning in terms of getting past those blocks that may have settled in there for eons, for generations, if you need to unblock, you need to move forward into the brand new experience of being your best self, we can help you with that. Okay? So today, let us know that we have a clear understanding of who we are, of how we are, of where we're going, and how to get there. And fear is not a part of that package. we know, and we know that we know. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day. Namaste.